Just imagine, average cost of living. See, another reason that many consider Panama, it's possible to live in Panama for as low as $1,000 per month.
Per month?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's like rent is 375 to 1200, whatever. Food is 400. Transportation is just $75 a month, which is like damn cheap, yeah? Mm-hmm. I pay more than $200 a month. Travel by rickshaws.
Mama, $75 a month. However, everything is cheaper.
Correct.
So for them, $75 a month is like $200 a month for us. Because we are converting it to that. I don't think they use USD. They use something else.
They use USD and... Panamian Balboa.
Oh, that Panamian Balboa will be like as rupees made if you count. US, everything will be cheap. Huh?
Good morning.
Sir, will you be taking only doubts or will you be teaching us?
Is your name Kareesh?
What, sir?
Who is Kareesh? He did replies. He typed a message, sir, will it be doubts or AC? AC ka chapter, is it pending?
Khatam ho gaya na.
Wait, banda, why is he typing doubts or AC?
Sir, kyunki aapne link doubt likha hai. Link ke isme aur flagship bola hai.
सर मैं एसी मींस ईएम
भी ईएम वेल्स यू डोंट विल डू टुडे
दिस स्क्रू के
इशू यस सर
फ्लैगशिप बैच है इसमें ईएम वेल्स हो गया ना यार
सर फ्लैगशिप नहीं है
सर हम लोग फ्लैगशिप नहीं है वो लिंक में आपने डाउन फ्लैगशिप लिखा है लेकिन
गलत लिखा
फ्लैगशिप इज आल्सो देयर
अरे भाई ये क्या कंफ्यूजन है यार ये कौन सा बैच है
तो फ्लैगशिप के टाइम टेबल में है अभी तो आपका फ्लैगशिप में लेक्चर है टाइम टेबल के साथ
हां मेरा टाइम टेबल फ्लैगशिप है
हमारा भी लेक्चर है आपके साथ
मैंने पीजीसी चीफ ऑफ का भी
हां सर
एनडी 1 2 बी में भी आपका लेक्चर
सर एनपीजीसी 3 4 5 वाले
दोनों का लेक्चर साथ में
है सर हमारा जैसे डाउट लेक्चर था
ओ भाई
और सिलेबस इज डन
फ्लैगशिप का सिलेबस इज डन The other batch is NAPJC 3, 4, 5
yes,
and associated batches, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is the confusion. Fine. That batch, mein, what was the last thing we covered?
Vernier calipers.
AC is over?
Yes, sir.
EM waves is left over for you people?
Yes, sir.
Now we will not be taking up EM waves. Uska alag si lecture lag raha hai. Now, today we have decided we will take doubts of HCV EMI. Is it okay with NAPJC 3-4 kits?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Sir, can you...
Sir, this will put in the channel, no? Recording.
I'll send the recording. On YouTube, I will not upload these doubts.
Okay, sir.
Sir, can you send yesterday's 9:45 recording?
Upload kiya na yaar.
Sir, it has vernier calipers. That's why I wanted. AC is over that hill.
Madam, vernier caliper hi to upload kiya hai maine. 9:45 kaun sa batch hai wo?
NAPJC 3-4-5 only, sir.
To wahi lecture shayad upload kiya hai maine.
Haan sir, kal YouTube pe raat mein aaya tha.
Okay, sir.
Vernier caliper, screw gauge, dono ka upload kiya hoga.
Okay, sir, I'll check.
सर हम लोग का स्क्रू गेज नहीं हुआ
सो स्क्रू गेज बाकी
आप कौन से बैच के हो भाई साहब
3-4-5
जब आपका अलग सा बैच क्लास हो रहा है याद दिला देना स्क्रू गेज विल टेक अर्ली 10-15 मिनट्स उसके बाद विल डील विद ईएम वेव्स राइट
तो सर अभी आप एचवी डाउट्स करवा रहे हैं ना
हां So today what was decided was HCV EMI doubts, right?
Sir. सर एक क्वेश्चन था सर, वो AITS पोस्टपोन होने वाला है क्या? आपने वो बात किया था वो
टुडे आई विल बी गोइंग टू अंजलि ऑफिस एंड टॉक टू द मैन एंड लेट यू नो. आई केप्ट देम इनफॉर्म दैट एट लीस्ट 3-4 डेज का टाइम तो दे दो बच्चों को, सो आई डोंट नो व्हाट दे विल डू.
ओके सर,
टॉक टू देम बाय इवनिंग एंड हैव अ नाइट.
Objective 2-5. Objective 2-5.
Objective 1-6. So in 2-4 also, objective 2-4. Sir, 24 from exercise.
Wait, let us finish objectives. Objective 1-6. You close the switch. 6th question. You close the switch. Current is increasing. That means magnetic field lines are increasing. This magnetic field is increasing. Increasing magnetic flux as the switch is closed. Now listen. Now magnetic field is this way, and this will be the north pole. Increasing magnetic field should be opposed, means this field should again be the north pole. So they both will repel. This is the north pole. Magnetic lines of poles are like this. Right?
Yes, sir. Got it.
So magnetic lines of poles are like this. This north pole, north pole. This should be north pole so that it opposes the increase. So it will repel. Objective 1. Objective 2, 4th question. Objective 2-4. A metal sheet is placed in front of a strong magnetic force. Metal sheet is placed in front of a strong magnetic pole. Not fair. Hypothetical question. This is a north pole. This is a metal sheet. Right? There will be induced a south pole and north pole. EMI mein kyun pucha bhai sahab isne? Ye to magnetism mein hona chahiye. Hold the sheet there if the metal is magnetic. See, this is a strong pole. This is not moving. So there will be no induced currents in this. No induced current, no induced EMF. Metal sheet is not moving. Did he give any condition where it is moving? CBIT, he says the metal is moving. Ab dhyan se suniye. Listen to the concept. If the pole or the plate is moving, there will be induced current in such a way such that it opposes the motion. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, if now metal, non-metal, non-metal me again there will be no induced current. I showed to you aluminium pipe me and steel pipe me, if resistance is more, no forces. Plastic pipe me you drop, there will be no forces. Now, if this is at rest, it depends on the magnetic nature. If this is a magnetic material, you will induce south pole and north pole. Then there will be attraction. Think for a second, I'll just be back in a minute. 1 second, wait. Yeah. The next is 5th question. A bar magnet is released from rest along the axis of a long constant current I is maintained in a solenoid. Which of the following quantities will increase if an iron rod is inserted into the C? B is equal to mu naught Ni. Now you introduce a paramagnetic material. It will be mu r, mu naught Ni. Magnetic field will increase, so the flux will increase. Current will decrease for your information. Self-inductance of the coil L is mu naught N square pi a square small n. Now it will become mu r. Self-inductance of the coil will also increase. Current will change because you are introducing for a fraction of a moment, current will change. That we already have done. You will conserve the flux. So Joule heating will happen. Are you people there?
Yes, sir.
Exercise
13 1 3
24 24
45
20
Sir 12
53
Sir,
17, 17, 46.
Sir, 62, 64. First, let us finish this lot. We start with 12, long solenoid, radius, number of turns, carries a current of this, a coil of radius, this having number of turns, total resistance is placed inside the solenoid coaxial. Coil is connected to a galvanometer. The current in the solenoid is reversed in direction, find the charge flown through the galvanometer. 12th question. Delta Q is 1 by R times delta phi. Do you people remember this?
Yes,
sir. We have done a reverse problem on this. Delta phi, this is a solenoid. Right? You keep a coil this way. Initially, B and A are in the same direction. After some time, you are rotating the direction of current. That means B is this way, A is this way. So delta phi is 2 times BA. B dot A, BA cos 0, BA cos 180. Subtract, it becomes 2 times BA. Substitute delta phi here, I will get delta Q.
Okay, sir.
I'll give you a hint. What will be the motional EMF? Rhombus, area, wo sab calculate karna hai kar sakte ho. But this will be the easiest way will be, can I find out V perpendicular? This is L. So motional EMF across, this will be B, L, V perpendicular into 4. There are 4 loops, 4 straight wires. So this V I will resolve perpendicular to the wire. At that instant, right? So BLV perpendicular into 4 is the induced EMF. Current BLV perpendicular into 4 divided by resistance. This will be dQ by dt. Take dt to the left. You know the time it takes for it. In that time, what is delta Q? All bits will be done. Now CBIT may delta Q is asking by the time it becomes flat. So you know the total change. CBIT may, you don't even need delta Q for the CBIT of this. Have a look. Delta Q is 1 by R times delta phi. Delta phi to aapko directly aa jaye. You know the initial area, you know the final area. Zero is the final area. Initial area of the rhombus calculate karna aata hai aapko. Delta phi aa gaya. Divide by R, you get the total delta Q. You don't need to do this. This need not be done. Can I rub the board?
Yes.
For which we'll have to read the 16th question. Square loop 5 centimeters move towards the right at a constant speed of 1 centimeter per second. The front edge enters the 20 centimeter wide magnetic field at t equal to 0. Find the EMF induced in the loop at t equal to 2 seconds, 10 seconds, 22 seconds, 30 seconds. Quite obviously, you'll be able to do that. Total heat produced in the loop of the previous problem during the time interval 0 to 30 seconds. If the resistance of the loop is 4.5 milli ohms, total heat produced, I square R.
Sir, I had a doubt that they had taken time is 5 seconds in the solution.
See, why they might have taken 5 seconds is once the loop is completely inside the magnetic field, there is no induced EMF and no current, right?
Yes.
So heat will be generated when it is entering and when it is leaving.
Yes.
30 seconds may, it will be from entering, will it leave? 30 seconds yes, may, sir. Will it leave?
Yes, sir.
So deal with just entering and leaving. When it was entering, there was current. When it was leaving, there was current. In between, there will be no current.
Achha, so that time we have to take when it is entering and when it is leaving.
Naturally, quite okay. Obvious. Because okay. Once it is totally inside, what is the induced electric field? Zero?
Zero. Thank you, sir.
Frontier is a genuinely tough question. Listen. You have a coil here. This is the coil. This is the battery. This is you. Right? Rheostat has a total length of L, agreed, and resistance R. The resistance of the coil is small r, a small circular loop of radius A dash and R dash is placed coaxially. This is A dash, the resistance is R dash, here the resistance is R. Here the resistance of the coil is R. A small circular loop of radius A dash and R dash is placed coaxially in the coil. Center of the loop is at a distance of X from here. Center is at a distance of X. Right? In the beginning, the sliding contact of the rheostat is at the left end. And then onwards, it is moved towards the right at a constant speed of V. This is moved towards the right with a constant speed of V. The length of this is L. Rheostat ka length is telling you is L. right? And resistance capital R. Resistance capital R. If this moves a distance of X, what will be the resistance inside? Resistance per unit length into L minus X will be the resistance inside. Intentionally, I am taking this as X so that you can put dx by dt as V. If I take the length inside as X, then dx by dt will be minus V. Do you agree with that?
Sir, can you take a different variable? X is already there above.
X is already there. We'll take this as Y. Then dy by dt, then this will be Y.
Yes.
That distance is given as X. Agreed. Smart. Right?
Yes.
Where am I? Find the EMF induced in the circular loop at a distance. Find the EMF induced in the circular loop at the instant. The contact begins to slide and it has slid through half the length of the resistor. When the contact EMF induced in the small circular loop at the instant contact begins to slide. That means from here. Right? When it is here, what is the resistance in this particular, what will be the current? It will be E divided by capital R plus small r. This is the current. Because of this, what will be the magnetic field here? Mu naught I, what is this radius E? A square by 2 into A square plus X square to the power 3 by 2 into pi A dash square will be the flux through this. Differentiate this flux, you get the answer. How will I differentiate this flux? Have a look at it. This I will substitute here. Don't differentiate this X. Don't differentiate this X. Right? What is the variable here? R is the variable. Put this particular resistance here. Instead of R, put it as R per unit length into L minus Y. What will I differentiate as dy by dt? Dy by dt will be velocity. Dy by dt will be velocity. Don't differentiate this X, it's a constant. Right? Dy by dt will be velocity. In these answers, you put y equal to 0, you get the initial instant. You put y equal to L by 2, you will get the instant at which it is at R, L by 2 or R by 2. Right?
Yes.
Sir? Sir, how can we calculate the mutual inductance between both the loops?
Mutual inductance कहाँ पूछा है इसने?
Sir, question number 96 में पूछा है. इस डायग्राम के लिए
96 तक जब जाएंगे तब करेंगे. म्यूचुअल इंडक्टेंस इन दोनों का हम लोगों ने क्लास में किया हुआ है. टू सर्कुलर लूप्स का किया हुआ है क्लास नोट्स में. हाउ कैन यू मिस ऑन दिस डायग्राम? इसमें
करंट
कैन आई रब द बोर्ड?
Yes, sir.
Now, next question is 24. A circular coil turns uniform magnetic field, EMF induced, average EMF induced in the coil over a long period, average of squares. We did this for AC circuits. B by dt of B dot A will be the induced EMF. He gave you number of turns, or number of turns is only one. Radius is given, number of turns, 80 revolutions per minute. Right, uniform magnetic field is given one turn. Wonderful. E will be equal to BA omega minus of sine ओमेगा टी बी ए ओमेगा साइन ऑफ ओमेगा वन सेकेंड हेलो वन सेकेंड One second, wait. Are you people able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Are you people able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. Now. B A W sine omega t. B is given, area is given, omega is given, sine omega t will not be difficult for you. Right? Average of the squares of this, what did you do? See, if you take E average over one complete time period B A omega, sine of omega t dt over one complete time period, over one time period, this will be zero. What is the other thing that we did? E RMS. Do you remember first you squared it, then you took the mean, then you took the root? This will become E naught by root 2. What is E naught? It will be this one. 24. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
You have a current generator IG shown in the figure, sends a constant current I through the circuit. The wire CD is fixed and AB is made to slide on the smooth, thick rails with a constant velocity V towards right. CD is fixed. Right. AB is given a velocity of B. This is A. And you have a constant current generated by the IG. You have a constant current generated by IG. Right? While CD is fixed, BB is made to slide on the smooth, thick rails with a constant velocity V towards right. With a constant velocity V towards right. Each of these wires are given a resistance of R. Find the current through the wire CD. Not a big deal. Each of these wires is given a resistance of R. That means, have a look. You have IG current through this. Right? You have a resistance of R. And you have a resistance of R here. And you have a battery also here. This is moving to the right. VBI. VBI. Right? DLB. What is the length? Length is AB. Length is given. Is the length given? Is the length given in this? Speak, 45. Length is not given in the question but given in the answer. Take that as BLV. Can you find out the current through CD now? This is C and D. Jiska bhi doubt hai. Please have a look at it. There is a constant current I and current because of this. Can you apply KVL? Are you people there?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Right. कोई बोल भी नहीं रहा है किसका क्वेश्चन है 45th समझ में आया कि नहीं इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट कैन यू फाइंड आउट द करंट इन सीरीज आईजी एंड द करंट ड्यू टू दिस सुपरपोजिशन प्रिंसिपल दे विल गेट सबट्रैक्टेड बिकॉज़ दे आर इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन एंड इन द आंसर दे हैव टेकन द लेंथ ऑफ दैट स्लाइडर टू बी एल व्हिच इज नॉट गिवन Right. Will somebody say something?
Yes, sir.
45th, kiska doubt tha? Namune milte yaar. Kiska doubt hai, class mein hai bhi. 46 किसका डाउट है
हां सर
हां नाउ 46 हैव अ लुक हियर अगेन यू हैव अ कांस्टेंट करंट जनरेटर राइट हियर IG इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन यू हैव अ स्लाइडर AB मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन Now, IG is shown in the figure, sends a constant current I through the current. The wire AB has a length L and mass M. Length L, mass M, this will be the magnetic field. The wire AB has a length L, mass M and can slide on the smooth horizontal rails connected by IG. The entire system lies in a vertical magnetic field when the velocity of the wave. So, class mein kiya hua hai maine. Current is maintained constant. Current maintained is constant. This is a current carrying source, right? IG shown in the figure sends a constant current I through the circuit. Now, you have a motional EMF. Resistance is given for this. Is there any resistance given for this?
No.
resistance not given. So there is nothing in this question. Current is maintained constant. So I have BIL. What is the acceleration? BIL by M. Velocity will be BIL by M into T. V is equal to U plus AT. This current generator maintains a constant current in the source. Once it maintains a constant current, the force on the wire will be BIL. By M is the acceleration. That is constant. So I can use V equal to U plus AT. Agreed? Is this clear? Figure shows a conducting disk rotating about its axis in a perpendicular magnetic field. A resistor of resistance R is connected between the center and the ring. Calculate the current in the resistor. Does it enter the disk or listen? This is nothing but a thin rod rotating with an angular velocity omega. You want between this point and this point. Right? It will be B omega L square by 2R. This will be the current. We have done this. Now see the directions by VBI.
Okay, sir.
Right, VBI, current flows in this direction, inside the rod. Now you know what is the direction of current.
Yes, of course.
Sixty-two means what he says is that this is rotating in clockwise direction. This has right, this will be EMFE, this will be O, this will be resistance R. Figure shows a situation similar to the previous problem. All parameters are the same except that a battery of EMFE and variable resistance R are connected between O and C. The connecting wires have zero resistance, no external force is applied on the rod. Except gravity forces by the magnetic field and by the pivot. Gravity is acting. This is in the vertical plane. Remember this. This is in the vertical plane. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
The rod rotates with uniform angular velocity in the clockwise direction. You have a magnetic field perpendicularly inwards. Right? Similar situation. Rod has a mass of M. The previous problem, we'll have to take the data from it. Rod has a mass of M and it's in the vertical plane. R is the resistance, right? Fine. So, in the clock, express your answer in terms of the given quantities and the angle theta made by the rod OA with the horizontal. OA. This is the value of theta that is asking. Theta, did I take the right value? Express your answer in terms of the given quantity. Quantities and the angle theta made by the rod OA with the horizontal. From this position it is rotating or has it come to this position? Are you people there?
Yes.
Right. Connecting wires, OC, a rod is made to rotate with uniform angular velocity in the clockwise direction, declaring a force at midpoint of a direction perpendicular to it. Find the magnitude of this force when the rod makes an angle of theta with the vertical. Fine. Now, figure shows all parameters are the same except for the battery variable resistance R are connected between O and C. The connecting wires have zero resistance. No external force is applied on the rod except for gravity. This is in what way should the resistance be changed so that the rod will rotate with uniform angular velocity in the clockwise direction? Express your answer. 1, 2. Have a look at it. In terms of theta, he means. So this will have a motional EMF of how much? B omega L squared by 2?
Yes, sir.
Right? You have a battery here of E. On the resistance variable R. Now, this is rotating in the clockwise direction. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
This is rotating in the clockwise direction. What did he ask? What way should the resistance be made? VBI. B is downwards. VBI. Agreed? B omega. What is the radius given? Radius kitna diya hua hai? Radius diya hua hai ki nahi question mein? How much?
A.
B omega A square by 2. Right? This is rotating with constant angular velocity. For it to rotate with constant angular velocity, you are asking me how should this be moved? This should be moved in such a way such that the current which you calculated in the previous situation, 61 and 62, please observe this. The problem is really tricky. This should be moved in such a way such that the torque on this should become zero. Torque on this should become zero. This should be moved in such a way such that the torque on this particular rod should become zero. Only then it will be rotated with uniform angular velocity.
Yes, sir.
Torque on this will be, this is mg. Mg into A, I am taking about 2. What will this perpendicular distance be? A cos theta. Mg into A cos theta. Right? Is my torque due to mg correct? A cos theta or A sin theta? This is A by 2, sorry. A by 2. This will be A by 2 cos theta. Agreed?
Yes.
Torque due to BIL. Torque due to BIL. Sum of both should become zero. The net torque on it becomes zero. The body will rotate with uniform angular velocity. Do you agree till here?
Yes, sir.
Now, the is there any other external force acting on it? Is there any other external force acting on it? BIL into A by 2. I'll assume all of BIL is acting at A by 2.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, I value, how will you get? Depending on the resistance. How will I get the I value? Here, negative, positive. See the polarity of the battery. Hope I have taken it correct. VBI. 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 I means the current will be going from negative to positive. Right? Right? These both are connected with the same polarities. This is positive, negative, negative, positive. Both will add up. I will be E plus B omega A square by 2 divided by the resistance. This resistance, this I will substitute here and you are asking me the value of R so that these both will remain. Next total torque will be zero. So R I will get in terms of theta?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? This R I will get in terms of theta. If I differentiate R, right hand side, theta's differentiation is omega?
Yes, sir.
I'll get rate at which R is changing?
Yes, sir.
He clearly wrote there is no external force acting on it. So only gravity and torque due to BIL. These both should cancel out each other. So I'll get R in terms of theta. Differentiate both. Differentiation of theta is omega, which is given. Differentiation of R is what he's asking. Problem is undoubtedly a bit tricky.
So you may erase the board. Now, what was the next? 64th May, have a look at it. It is nothing but creating a small confusion here. Here, they want to know the value of the magnetic field at the point P. Am I right? Yes, sir.
Point P on the side of the square circumscribing the circle. Now have a look at it. If the point P is here, can I find out this distance? I'll call this R dash. So here I will get induced electric field this way. Can I resolve it along this direction? I call it theta E cos theta. By the way, E is R dash by 2 dB by dt. Usne dB by dt diya hai. R dash you can calculate, e cos theta you can calculate. This is theta 90 minus theta, this is theta. Agreed?
Yes, sir. So you can erase.
Tell me the balance doubts, exercise HCV. After 64.
85.
Was 85. LR circuit with EMF is connected at T equal to 0. Find the charge Q that flows through the battery between 0 to T. Calculate the work done by the battery. Heat develop. Sorry. Heat developed. Verify that the results in the three parts are consistent with the energy conservation. Work done by the battery. Heat developed during a magnetic field energy. Fifth question. Didn't we already deal with this? You have a battery here. Didn't we deal with EIDT is equal to LIDI plus I square RDT? Rather, we used this to calculate the energy stored. This is the work done by the battery. This half Li square is the energy. We dealt with this two ways. First, we found out half Li square. Then we found out even this. This is the heat development. This is the work done by the battery. Ki kine? Kuch to bolo.
Yes, sir.
Right. And then? In the other bit, they're asking you for the charge. You know the current, I naught into 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. This is dq by dt. Take dt to the right and integrate. You get the charge flow in time t. Shall I tell you people one thing? You people have not solved HCV.
No, sir.
People solved HCV, baki logon ne kiya nahi. Oh, bhai sahab, sun lo. Ek baat dhyan se suno. This last chapter, EMI, is very important. In a hurry to revise and start your 8 years, please don't screw up this chapter. There were days when che questions this chapter se aaye. 2006 and 7 and 8 ka paper dekh lo, 6 questions from EMI. Please solve HCV and the book. Nahi karoge, so you will be paying a very heavy price for it. Pura mechanics se 3 questions aayenge, is ek chapter se 6 questions aayenge, ab is chapter ko aap chhod doge to. Aisa samjhaun tum logon ko, meri samajh ki baat hai. किया नहीं आप लोगों ने चैप्टर ढंग से प्लीज कंप्लीट इट सीवी भी करना है बुकलेट भी करना है अब आधा आधा काम मत किया कर दिया इट सीवी पूरा करना है इट सीवी का ईएमआई थोरोली कर लो जेई मेंस का आपने कंसोलिडेट कर दिया बस जेई मेंस बेट्स सीटी मणिपाल वेलूर में जो ईएमआई क्वेश्चंस आते हैं इसी लेवल के आते हैं बस दैट्स ऑलरेडी इन योर हैंड बुकलेट ढंग से करो यार पॉइंट वर्ड्स जी एडवांस मगर करो तो सही ये लंबा चैप्टर है बड़ा चैप्टर में पहले से बताते जा प्लीज यूज नेक्स्ट 3-4 डेज आप इन्वेस्ट करो 3-4 दिन पूछ लो आई एग्री अंडरस्टैंड दैट अदर टॉपिक्स आर अदर सब्जेक्ट्स आर आल्सो प्रेशर ऑन यू पीपल बट राइट नाउ इतना इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर को डाइल्यूट नहीं कर सकते अभी यू लीव इट यूर डूम ये फिर से आपको रिवाइज करने के लिए यू हैव टू गो थ्रू ऑल द लेक्चर्स कितने लेक्चर्स 12 लेक्चर्स लिए हमने ईएमआई का इतने लेक्चर्स रिवाइज करने के लिए कितना टाइम लगेगा आपको बताइए 12 इनटू से इफेक्टिवली इवन इफ इट इज 1 1/2 आवर फास्ट फॉरवर्ड कर one complete, two complete days you will take even for revision of this. Right now, complete. Pavan Kiyan. EMI ka doubts put say or HCV se. Sirf do genuine doubts pucha hai aap logon ne. 62nd problem genuine doubt, 64th problem genuine. Baki sab don't fool yourself. This chapter is very important. Bar bar go wrong. Please do this chapter. आपका बोर्ड्स का शेड्यूल कुछ आया हुआ है, पता चला आपको?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, आज से डोंट बिकम नर्वस. कोई बड़ी बात है नहीं बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन, मगर डोंट नेग्लेक्ट. आज से एक घंटा बोर्ड्स के लिए दीजिए. हाउ डू आई गिव दैट? आपके HSC के टेक्स्ट बुक है आपके पास, हर किसी के पास है कि नहीं?
Yes, sir.
HSC के टेक्स्ट बुक के पीछे के जो क्वेश्चंस है, ढंग से आप उन क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स रिप्रोड्यूस करना. 1 hour पर डे एवरी डे गिव सिंसियर. 1 hour पूरा प्रोडक्टिव होना चाहिए. लिखो, सो के पढ़ने का नहीं HSC का टेक्स्ट बुक, बैठ के लिखो. एंड लिखना आंसर वो टेक्स्ट बुक के पीछे जो क्वेश्चन है. क्वेश्चन पेपर अभी बता रहा हूं मैं, अभी बता रहा हूं क्वेश्चन पेपर. वही क्वेश्चन आएंगे जो टेक्स्ट बुक के पीछे, वो छोड़ के एक दो क्वेश्चन आएंगे जो जेई मेंस से छोटे लेवल के, जो बड़ा आराम से कर लेंगे आप. मगर डेरिवेशन जो HSC टेक्स्ट बुक दिया हुआ है उसी तरह लिखना है. सो टेक्स्ट बुक के पीछे क्वेश्चन देखो, उसका आंसर उसी तरह लिखो जिस तरह टेक्स्ट बुक में दिया हुआ. एक घंटा पर डे दे दो, आराम से 85-90% मिल जाए. राइट? डोंट पैनिक, डोंट पुट प्रेशर ऑन योरसेल्फ फ्रॉम ऑल डायरेक्शंस. कैटेगराइज योर टाइम. HSC का गिव 1 hour पर डे, स्लोली इंक्रीज दैट. जनवरी फर्स्ट वीक से मेक इट 1.5 hours. जनवरी 15th से मेक इट 2.5 hours. दैट वे व्हेन यू आर क्लोजिंग कमिंग टू द बोर्ड्स गिव मोर टाइम. राइट? पता नहीं क्या करेंगे, तो इस तरह तो नहीं होगा. EMI चैप्टर छोड़ो मत, आज कल खत्म कर दो. प्लीज खत्म कर दो, बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर है.
यस सर.
पता नहीं किसी बैच में मैंने 3-block सिस्टम का एक स्टेज किया है कल, कौन सा बैच में किया है मुझे याद नहीं. फ्लैगशिप में किया है. NAPJC 3-4 में वर्नियर कैलिपर वॉइस 2 gauge करना है. अब इसमें से आधे बच्चे निकल गए, पता नहीं. टुमारो वी हैव ए क्लास विद ओल्ड APJC 3-4-5.
नो सर.
तो फिर कल क्लास लोगे क्या? कोई मैसेज पूछ रहा है मुझे ओल्ड APJC 3 से.
सर टुमारो वी डोंट हैव एनी क्लास.
टुमारो यू पीपल डोंट हैव एनी क्लास?
नो सर.
हां देन टुमारो आई शेड्यूल्ड वन ओल्ड APJC 3-4 किट्स. टुमारो आई शेड्यूल्ड वन टू कवर screw gauge and if possible EM waves or 3-block systems, one of them. Right?
Yes sir.
In your group. Booklet shuru kiya EMI ka aap logon ne?
So I started 50 questions I did from first exercise.
50 is a good score. In fact even that I'm happy. 50 bhi kiya abhi tak, I'm happy. नेक्स्ट वीक विल हैव ओनली डाउट लेक्चर्स. उसमें आप जो डाउट्स खत्म करेंगे क्लियर करते जाओ. मतलब खत्म तो करो. डोंट गेट फ्राइटेंड ऑल ऑफ अ सडन सीइंग योर बोर्ड शेड्यूल्ड. आई अंडरस्टैंड इनिशियली इट विल बी अ बिट पैनिकी. द बैलेंस यू मेंटेन द बेटर. राइट? 1-1.5 hour पर डे देते जाओ. आपको क्वेश्चन पेपर अभी से बता रहा हूँ, टेक्स्ट बुक के पीछे का क्वेश्चन आएंगे. और क्या चाहिए? लास्ट ईयर का पेपर्स देख लो, लास्ट 2 years का पेपर्स. लास्ट ईयर तो कंडक्ट नहीं हुआ, उसके पहले साल वो सॉल्व कर दो एक दो बार.
यू विल बी ऑन द राइट ट्रैक, सरप्लस, उससे ज्यादा करने की जरूरत है भी नहीं, 85-90% आराम से आ रहा है, फाइन, डू दैट, गो कॉन्फिडेंटली एंड प्लीज कंप्लीट HCV एंड booklet. You people have not done HCV. The way you ask doubts, I can make it up. Handful of people have done. Go save your time. Please work out. See you people in the next class. Flagship ka kab hai next lecture?
Sir, next week hi hoga.
Doubts lenge flagship ka. So please complete. Ab jo complete karenge uska doubts lenge. Right?
Yes, sir. Sir, aap 3 block ka recording upload kar denge?
3 block ka recording already hai, kiya hua hai. Junior batch ke liye kiya hua hai. Friction chapter mein hai. लास्ट स्टेजेस में है, फ्रिक्शन का लास्ट लेक्चर और दैट प्रीवियस लेक्चर में है 3 ब्लॉक का, आपके जूनियर बैच में फ्रिक्शन चैप्टर में ही ले लिया.
ओके सर,
गुड डे
सर. दिस लेक्चर, टुडेस लेक्चर यू विल सेंड ना रिकॉर्डिंग?
भेज दूंगा, अभी भेज दूंगा.
ओके सर, थैंक यू.